everybody. I'm Tom Vasel, and I'm talking about my favorite kids' games that we played together with my family this year in 2021. There's a lot of kids' games that come out every year, and most of them are straight-up trash. I think there's a lot of great ones, though, ones that you will have fun, you as an adult, playing with the kids, or at least the kids will have fun playing by themselves. Here are 10 great ones that came out this year, my favorites. Number 10, we have Pebble Rock Delivery Service. This is a game in which you are this little animal sea captain sailing around, picking up deliveries and delivering them to different spots. You can kind of decide how fast you want to go, although if you're fast, too fast, the shark and the pirate might come after you. This game has one of the most gorgeous presentations of any kids game that's out there. It really looks great, and kids like it because you have to decide how far and how fast you want to move as you go pick up things and deliver them. Pebble Rock Delivery Service. Number 9 is Hungry Hugo. Of all the games on this list, this is probably the simplest one. There's this gorilla, Hugo, who's going around and smashing down the decorations that you're putting around your house. This is a very simple card game. You play cards, put decorations up. You play cards to send Hugo at somebody else. You roll a die. Sometimes he goes after the person who sent him. It's silly fun, and my kids just really enjoyed it, especially my youngest, as you get to play cards and move Hugo around and knock over stuff from your opponents. Number eight is Necromolds. Necromolds is a miniatures game where you have things, these weird creatures that you summon who go attack your opponent's creatures. Why would I want to play that with kids? Because all the creatures are made of Play-Doh, essentially. You make them, and when you defeat your opponent's creatures, you smash it into a pile of goop. Now, what kid doesn't like that? The answer is they all love it. It's really entertaining. And the game actually comes with some advanced rules. So if you want to play Necromolds against other adults or older kids, it works there. But even for younger kids, there's a very simple set of rules where you just basically move, roll some dice, see if you hit, and then if you hit, smash. Everyone loves smashing Play-Doh things. You always want to break your opponent's pieces. This is a game where it's perfectly legitimate to do so. And it's also fun putting your army together at the beginning by putting the Play-Doh in these different molds, the Necromolds. Number 7 is Dreamcatcher. This is a simple game, but what it does is it uses some visual perception. You have these different monsters and dreams things, and you need to cover them with discs. But you need to figure out what disc you can cover them with. Are you going to pick the smallest disc? It gives you more points, but it might not cover them, and you have to kind of judge this visually. Very simple concept, but many kids' games are based on such a simple concept. And this one I found the kids did better at me many times at judging just what will cover up the different cards that you flip over. So that's Dreamcatcher. Number 6 is Ghost Adventures. So now we get to games that use a unique gimmick. This one uses a spinning top. In this game, you are spinning a top and moving around this top on a different board. But here's the thing, I need to get it from one board to another board. I'm trying to accomplish different missions. So you're holding one board and I'm gonna move it to the top, goes onto your board, and then you move it and go to a different spot. And we might need to flip the board over and get to the other side. And there's little holes and things in the boards, which basically are difficult things that you want to avoid. It's a cooperative game that everyone's going to like a lot. It comes with a little comic book instructions. It's silly fun, but it's all about balancing that top and trying to make it go where you want to go. Kids will enjoy this. Adults will find it to be quite hard for them also, and has bright, colorful artwork. It's a lot of fun. That's Ghost Adventures. Well, same thing here with number 5, which is Catapult Kingdoms. This is essentially a reworking of Weapons and Warriors as a kid, where you have all these different things that you can get for this. Catapults and trebuchets and crossbows and catapults, and you're shooting different objects, and one of the sets comes with the little beehives that bounce all over the place, but usually they're little balls at your opponent's creatures, and they're little soldiers in their towers. This is a toy. It's a toy for sure. It's a game, and there's lots of fun, and so you look at my review of it. I talked about all the different pieces that you get for it, but it is entertaining. I have strong nostalgia of playing crossbows and catapults and weapons and warriors when I was a kid. This brings it back, and it does so in a good way so that I can introduce this to my son, who's like, wow, we get to shoot things at each other, and I'm still having a blast. Sometimes you just want to play, and Catapult Kingdoms allows you to do so. Number 4 is Hammer Time. Yes, yes, not that song. This game, you flip the box over, put some gems on it, and hit it with a hammer, trying to knock off not too many gems, because then you bust, and the right colors to match your cards. Very simple, but knowing how hard to hit the box, what side to hit the box on, and again, this is one where kids and adults can play on a very even keel. This is another one that we played live here on the Dice Tower. You can see me playing it with my son. See how much he enjoys it. This game works for all ages, but is especially good for the younger set. All right, the top three games here are just absolutely phenomenal, and I think everyone should get them if you have kids. Number three, Kids Chronicles Quest for the Moonstones. There's a very popular adult game called Chronicles of Crime, in which you go around and you scan QR codes with your phone, and you solve a murder mystery. I don't know if I want my kids to be playing something with gruesome murders, but in this one, Quest for the Moonstones, it's very similar to that, where you're going to go through this fantasy adventure and play through and find out the missing prince or whatever the story of the day is. You get to some locations and you have to pick the phone up and look around, find items, you use cards. So it's a kind of a marriage of technology with a board game, but it does so very seamlessly and is just so entertaining. Very highly recommend it. Number two, which has a very similar name. So number three was Kids Chronicles, Quest for the Moonstones. Number two is just Quest Kids. This is a game in which you, again, it's cooperative, and I found cooperative games really work well for kids. In fact, all three of my top games are cooperative. But in this game, you are kind of doing a dungeon crawl. You're moving your characters through and flipping cards over. And even though the theme of it's cooperative, there's still one winner at the end of this one because you're trying to get points by going around and defeating monsters. But this game teaches cooperation because you help other players. I can't beat my monster. Oh, I can give you some cards to help you beat them. But then you get a reward for doing that. So yes, you're kind of helping people for a reward, which is probably not the best way in real life, but it does reinforce that, hey, help other people. And the game works so well in this regard. It's so fun, and you go through different missions. And so, yeah, I call this cooperative. I guess it's more semi-co-op because the theme is co-op. We're all fighting the different monsters as the different heroes. But there is one winner each time. But also, there's a whole another pack you can add to add a whole storyline to it. But it's so much fun and easy to play. And some of the best experiences I've had this year was playing this with my son. Number one, my favorite kids game of 2021 is Yummy Yummy Monster Tummy. This is another game that uses scanning technology. For this one, I use my iPad. You can use your phone. Different monsters show up, and you have a handful of cards, and you are feeding these monsters by putting them over it, letting the camera scan it to feed them, and you're trying to mesh together colors to match that color. So the monster might be purple. You have a red card. I have a blue card. Boom, we got it. But with three players, you have a red, I have a blue, you have this greenish card. Is that the combination of colors? This is a game I would want to play as an adult. I don't know what it is about this game. We've played this game more than any other game on this list. It's so much fun. It just, you play it over and over and over again. The name sounds ridiculous. Yummy, yummy, monster tummy. But it's a fun game that, once again, marries that technology. You're using an iPad, but not as that. It's sitting on a table. It's like part of the board game. And then using these cards, and it has a little bit of a story progression, and you add more cards to the deck. Sometimes you have to play everything in black and white. It's such a unique, interesting experience that is just a blast to play. So these are my 10 favorite kids games from 2021. I recommend that you check them out for kids of all different ages. Hopefully this gives you some ideas. I'm Tom Vasel, and you've been watching the Dice Tower.